special edition. And the important story at this moment which we are tracking is that after assuming charge as a defense minister in the second Modi government, Rajnath Singh, the defense minister, will visit Siachen Glacier and Srinagar today to review security preparedness along the borders with Pakistan and interact with field commanders and soldiers there. Singh, who will be accompanied by Army Chief General Bipin Rawat, will also take stock of the anti-terror operations in Jammu and Kashmir. Top army officials in the state will also brief the defense minister about the security scenario along the border and on anti-terror operations. And several ministers took charge of their ministries in the second Modi government today. BJP MP from Chandni Chowk, Harshvardhan, took charge as the Union Health Minister for the second time today. He served as Health Minister and was later given the charge of the ministries of Earth Sciences and Science and Technology in the previous Modi government.
मैं बहुत सौभाग्यशाली हूँ कि मुझे इससे पहले प्रधानमंत्री जी ने तीन महत्वपूर्ण विभागों की जिम्मेदारी पिछले पाँच सालों में दी, साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्थ साइंसेस और पिछले दो साल में मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट, फॉरेस्ट एंड क्लाइमेट चेंज। और आज भी स्वास्थ्य एवं परिवार कल्याण मंत्रालय के साथ साथ उन्होंने मुझे साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी की और मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्थ साइंसेस की जिम्मेदारी दी है।
एंड बीजेपी एमपी फ्रॉम पटना साहिब रवि शंकर प्रसाद टुक चार्ज ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ लॉ एंड जस्टिस। प्रसाद हैज रिटेन्ड द आईटी एंड लॉ मिनिस्ट्रीज इन द सेकेंड इनिंग्स ऑफ द मोदी गवर्नमेंट। ही इज ऑल्सो अपॉइंटेड एज द टेलीकॉम मिनिस्टर दिस टाइम।
हमारी सरकार को बहुत ही निर्णायक बहुमत मिला है और इस निर्णायक बहुमत में लीगल एक्सेस, लीगल एजुकेशन और इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, इन जस्टिस डिलीवरी, इन तीनों का बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण स्थान है। ये बहुत सुखद संयोग है कि माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने मुझे संचार और आईटी का भी विभाग दिया है, तो एक साइनर्जी बनाकर टेक्नोलॉजी के माध्यम से एक्सेस टू जस्टिस को और इफेक्टिव किया जाए, ये हमारी पूरी कोशिश होगी। इट विल बी अ प्रायोरिटी एरिया। दूसरा विषय जो मैं बहुत ही गंभीरता से देखूंगा कि ऑल इंडिया जुडिशियल सर्विस के लिए स्टेक होल्डर कंसल्टेशन को एक्सपेडाइट किया जाए। जैसा मैंने पहले भी कहा है कि हम चाहते हैं कि जुडिशियल अपॉइंटमेंट्स में अच्छे लोग आए, उसका सिलेक्शन प्रोसेस और अधिक मेरिट बेस्ड हो।
And General V.K. Singh also took charge as the Minister of State in the Ministry of Road, Transport and Highways today. Singh served as MOS in the External Affairs Ministry in the previous Modi government.
Unlike other ministries, this ministry already has priorities. And those priorities are to ensure that whatever infrastructure is required by the nation, that gets completed in as fast a time frame as is possible.
And what are the challenges?
Are hindi pucho yaar sare hindi.
Challenges will always be there when you deal with infrastructure, you deal with so many issues in which constructions are involved. All those are challenges, and the biggest challenge is how to overcome any challenge that comes.
And former Jharkhand Chief Minister Arjun Munda also took charge as Minister of Tribal Affairs. Munda had won Jharkhand's Khunti seat after narrowly beating his nearest Congress rival by 1,445 votes. And Smriti Irani, BJP MP from Amethi, took charge of the Women and Child Development Ministry. Smriti Irani has also retained the charge of Textiles Ministry, a portfolio she held during the first term of the Modi government. And some more developments. The Supreme Court has directed the CBI to complete its investigations in the Muzaffarpur shelter home abuse case within 3 months. In its latest order today, a two-judge vacation bench directed the CBI to look into the allegations of murder of 11 girls by key accused Brijesh Thakur. The investigation agency has also been ordered to investigate allegations of unnatural sexual assault under Section 377 of the Indian Penal Code and probe video recordings of the assault on girls at the shelter home. The bench asked the probe agency to investigate the role of outsiders who were involved and facilitated sexual assaults of inmates after administering them intoxicants. Several girls were allegedly raped and sexually abused at the NGO-run shelter home. The issue had come to light following the report by the Tata Institute of Social Sciences. The Supreme Court had taken over the monitoring in the case from the Patna High Court in September last year. A Delhi court today allowed Robert Vadra, accused in the money laundering case, to travel abroad for 6 weeks. The court allowed him to travel to USA and the Netherlands for 6 weeks and asked him to submit his travel schedule. The court, however, did not allow Vadra, brother-in-law of Congress President Rahul Gandhi, to go to London. Advocate appearing for the Enforcement Directorate had opposed Vadra's plea in which he had sought permission to travel to the UK and other countries, citing health reasons. Vadra is facing allegations of money laundering in purchase of a property in London worth £1.9 million. And some more big developments. India has reacted strongly to the unprecedented level of harassment meted out to the guests invited to the Indian High Commission's iftar party in Islamabad. In a press release, High Commissioner Ajay Bisaria on Sunday asked Pakistan to urgently investigate these ugly events and share the results. On Saturday evening, the invitees to the iftar party faced major problems due to enhanced security checks by the Pakistani officials, who stopped them on one pretext or the other. The annual event was hosted by Indian High Commissioner at Serena Hotel, for which guests were invited from all over Pakistan. Protesting the incident, the Indian High Commission said the incident not only violated the basic norms of diplomatic conduct, but was against all the norms of civilized behavior and entirely counterproductive for our bilateral relationship. RBI's three-day monetary policy meeting will begin in Mumbai today. The MPC, headed by RBI Governor, will meet for 3 days to firm up the second bi-monthly monetary policy of the fiscal. Economic experts believe that RBI may go to another round of rate cut to prop up the economic growth, which dropped to a five-year low in the final quarter of 2018-19. The central bank had cut the short-term lending rate, also known as the repo rate, by 25 basis points each in its last two review policies. And weather news now. India Meteorological Department has predicted a decrease in the severity of heat wave, which has gripped most parts of the northern and western India. In a tweet, the Met Office said, due to easterly winds at lower levels in northern parts of the country, the severity of the heat wave is likely to decrease over Punjab, Haryana, Chandigarh, Delhi and Uttar Pradesh from today. Meanwhile, several parts of the country reeled under heat wave condition that claimed one life in Rajasthan, where Churu recorded a high of almost 49 degrees Celsius on Sunday. Met Department said severe heat wave conditions are likely to persist over Madhya Pradesh and West Rajasthan today. The summer sun continued to beat down on Jammu as Sunday's maximum temperature settled at 42.5 degrees Celsius. Meanwhile, in Odisha, heatwave conditions continued unabated, with temperature soaring above 40 degrees Celsius, at least at 10 places. The hill state of Himachal Pradesh also got some respite from the heatwave following light rains, in which some parts, temperature at some parts was brought down. In Uttarakhand, one person was killed in a cloudburst in Chamoli as heavy rain lashed the district and neighboring Almora. Meanwhile, IMD has said the sluggish pace of monsoon has further delayed its onset over Kerala to 7th of June. International developments now. In a significant move to increase the surveillance of those seeking to enter United States, the country will now ask the visa applicants to provide information on their use of social media in the last 5 years under new rules. Online visa forms that require social media account history became operational at the end of the last week and will cover all applicants except those applying for certain official and diplomatic visas. The move is aimed at enhancing the vetting of foreign nationals and to screen out terrorists and other dangerous individuals seeking entry into America. The rule is expected to affect close to 15 million people annually. And now the news from the ongoing ICC Cricket World Cup 2019, where the Bangladesh caused the severe upset to the tournament by beating South Africa 21 runs at the Oval on Sunday. After losing the toss, Bangladesh was put into bat by the Proteas. The team posted their highest one-day international score as ferocious hitting from Mushfiqur Rahim and Shakib Al-Hassan took them to 330 for six. Mushfiqur made 78 from 80 balls and Shakib's 75 came from 84 balls as their pair combined in a 142-run partnership. Chasing the victory target of 331 runs, South Africa could score only 309 for 8 in the stipulated 50 overs. South Africa has lost both its match in the tournament so far and will now face India on Wednesday. Meanwhile, in today's match, host England will take on Pakistan at Nottingham at 3 p.m. Indian time. And that's all we have for you in this edition. Thank you for watching.